Quick question for you. Do you have a flow to your real estate investment business? Well, my name is Jerry Green. I'm going to take a little time to share that with you today. But do me a favor. If you would, make sure to subscribe to my channel here. Give me a thumbs up and I'll continue to share content. So let's talk a little bit about this here. The flow of your real estate investment business. So what in the heck does that mean? Well, you know, it's interesting because I never really thought about this. For many, many years, I never thought about there actually being a flow to my business. If you think about it, it's nothing more than you think about it like a production line process, okay? So I started thinking about this and I thought, well, wait a minute. I mean, you see so many businesses that have this in place. And really the best example of this, guys, is a franchise type model, okay? You think a franchise type model, like such as McDonald's, okay, they are very focused towards their overall processes that they have, and all those processes tie into basically operating systems. And they have then a master operating system with multiple layers below that. But if you look at it though, everything has a beginning and an end to it. Okay, so it starts somewhere, flows through a process, and ends somewhere. Well, you know, I started thinking about this. Why couldn't we do the same thing with real estate investing? And, you know, I started working with this year, and this has been years ago, but I started laying this out. And I said, you know what, there is. I mean, we have a flow to the business. I started laying this out and I realized, okay, there's a beginning to the production line process. There's an end to that. So what are all those steps? And what if we took those steps, lay them all out from beginning to end, created an actual flow chart on that, and we could turn around and then one, our own team could understand that, and then they could understand each department, how it ties in together and creates an end result. And at the same time, we would have it set up too where we could even train our students that way. So we start working with people and they said, hey, I can just take your flow and learn that and understand how your business works. And guess what, guys? We were able to use that. And then part of understanding this is really how you start the foundation of building the scalability in your real estate investment business. Now, one of the things that I want to share with you also today is I think it's important for you to understand that not only do you need to set up a flow for your, you know, just overall for your real estate business, but you need to set up for each, what I call each product line in your business. Now think about this, okay? This is where most investors really drop the ball on this. What happens is they're in a position where they think wholesaling, rehabbing, rentals, and all that, they pretty well look at it, it's all this real estate investing, so it's the same thing, right? Well, they're wrong. Think about it, guys. If I'm in any other business and I'm producing, let's just say, you know, it could be any type of widget, and let's I have these particular widgets I'm doing, then I want to maybe do some additional types of widgets that have some special features to them, okay, or a completely different type of widget. Well, when I'm doing that, each one of those may have a different flow in regards to producing that widget or providing that service for a client. Well, we do the same thing when it comes to real estate investing. Like, wholesaling is a whole different flow. Majority of it is. Wholesaling is a different flow versus rehabbing. There's some of the different parts, or the moving parts are gonna be the same as the wholesale business compared to rehabbing. But the other parts are gonna be completely different. In the same way, if you're buying to hold, there's gonna be different parts of the business that are completely different than, you know, another, you know, different model we might be doing, like wholesaling or wholetailing or fixing or flipping or rentals. So all of them have different flows to them. So one of the best things I can tell you to do is to take some time and write out the flow of your business, okay? And that will have a major impact on how you can actually approach your business to prepare it for scalability. Because let me tell you something here. If you're in a position where you never take the time to do this, you will never be able to scale your real estate investment business. I can promise you that. Because if you don't understand all the moving parts and lay that out where you can create a visual for somebody else to see that, and they can step in and say, hey, I see how this all works. And if they can't be able to do that, then, you know, think about it. There's no way it's going to be a scalable model. It's like a McDonald's. If I had a McDonald's franchise that I was setting up and I basically brought people in and I never gave them any flow of the business, of how it works from the time somebody comes in the front door there and orders something, or if they're ordering on an app, or if they're going through a drive-through, and how it goes from being basically taken order to how they pay, to how things prepare, the timing of things, and how it's given to the customer. If I don't do all that, how are they going to be able to serve people? Okay, you think it sounds so simple, but the thing is, there's a lot of complexity there, and it's well oiled, and that's why you don't really think about it. Well, you can do the same thing for your real estate investment business, guys, because I've done it. And by doing this, this is what allows you to start removing yourself from all these moving parts. And that's how I've been able to take it down to the point where, you know, I can work actually, you know, on my business no more than the average about 3 hours a week, and the team does the rest. But it's not just the team, that's they do the work, but also it ties into the flow of the business, because they understand how that works and how each department all ties together. Guys, this is a very powerful tool if you apply it. So I suggest that you take some time and just write out the flow of your business. And once you understand that, make sure your team understands that. Or if you don't have a team, make sure you understand it well enough that you can prepare a team at some future date. To me, I think this is one of the most impactful things you can ever do in your real estate investment business. I hope this helps, guys, and you can make a bigger impact in your future as you grow your business here. So do me a favor, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done that, and like my video here and share it to others. Talk to you soon.